You call this cooperation between harbingers? Cooperation involves communication, you know.
Don't take it to heart, child. Besides, aren't you happy that you got to skip the formalities and bring chaos to the land? I'm sure you must have enjoyed that. Oh, it seems that some of your friends have arrived.
Hey, it's Zhongli and Child. And... you! You're also one of the Harbingers?
It's you two. I believe we've met once before. In the City of Bards, was it? I'm glad you still remember my name. Ah, right. I imagine that it must have been rather hard to forget watching helplessly as something precious was snatched away from your friend.
No! Don't let her get to you! You've yet to gather the powers of all seven elements, and our last battle at the Golden House was almost more than you could handle. So it might be best to keep things peaceful this time, seeing that two of the Harbingers are here.
Well, if it isn't you two. This is our first time seeing each other since Liyue was nearly wiped off the map. This is certainly a bit awkward, wouldn't you say?
Paimon knew that we should never have trusted a Fatui Harbinger.
Oh, now don't say that. Sure, I may have misled you, but I never had anything against you personally. Besides, I thought we were getting along quite well together, didn't you? Except for that little tussle we had at the end. Nothing personal. We just have different views, that's all. Of course, you may very well hold this against me, but that's up to you. The real deceivers here are Senora and Zhongli. Curse them for leading me on. So actually, I think...
Stop wasting time, child. There'll be plenty of time to chat once I'm through here. You remember the agreement, Morax. Now, if you would be so kind. The Gnosis, please.
What in the world are you talking about?
The contract is fulfilled. That which thou seeketh is now bestowed unto thee. For my promise is solid as stone.
How sanctimonious.
What? So you're the Lord of Chio? No, wait! That's an exciting twist and all, but why give the Gnosis to the Fatui?
I do not give it for free. I give it as agreed upon in the contract, for it is a matter solely between the Tsaritsa and I.
Yeah, you don't think you went a little bit too far with that whole fake death thing? Everyone was preparing the ceremony for you, and splat! This big dragon falls out of the sky, and all of Lyric goes into an uproar! Talk about a disaster!
Gathering all the forces that had been bubbling behind the scenes, and then stirring them together in a pot that was bound to boil over. That's what he wanted to see, am I right?
Wait, what?
Perhaps it's best that I explain. As you know, I've dwelt upon this world for more than 6,000 years. It is now 3,700 years ago that I founded Liyue together with the Adepti. Even boulders that can withstand whirlpools will erode with the passing of time. I kept convincing myself that cracks had not begun to form, and that the end of my time had not yet come. Until one drizzly day, as I was strolling along the harbor, I heard a merchant tell one of his workers, You finished your duties. Go ahead and call it a day. I stood motionless among the crowds, asking myself, have I already finished my duties?
Oh, Zhongli.
But as I began to consider relinquishing my divine role, I soon discovered that many reasons still remained to not hastily depart. Was Liyue, the city I had dwelt in for so long, already prepared to enter its next age? I decided that a test was needed in order to reveal the answer. So I feigned my own death, and gathered the cast of Child, the Adepti, and the Liyue Qixing to play their roles together on the stage that was Liyue. That's right. Which is why I continued to safeguard the Gnosis until now.
So you mean that if the Chaos ever reached the point of no return, you would simply appear and use your divine powers to bring Liyue back under control?
Of course. And it would have been all too easy for him, too. Just as a child quickly matures after losing their parents, so has Liyue matured when faced with the death of its deity.
In the end, the resolution to all that has transpired was even more satisfactory than I could have hoped for. Take the Adepti, for instance. Owing to their years of seclusion, they were the least informed. Yet when faced with a crisis, they commendably showed the greatest amount of restraint possible. Not only did they manage to cooperate with the Qixing, but in the end, they even made efforts to understand the hearts of the people. Credit is also due to Signora, the emissary dispatched by the Cryo Archon to fulfill our contract. At my request, she kept everything she knew in strict confidence. This despite the eavesdropping ears of her colleague, Child. This meant I could remain as Zhongli, even having the chance to fulfill the age-old traditions of Liyue in this mortal form. Thank you for joining me on this journey, Traveler. All of these things turned out as I had planned. There is only one thing that I had not anticipated, and that was the conduct of the Liyue Qixing. I had expected them to do no more than the Adepti, to come to the defense of Liyue. But when all was said and done, they seized the opportunity to supplant Liyue's divine protectors, and used the subsequent power vacuum left by my death to quickly gain complete control of Liyue.
That doesn't sound good at all.
On the contrary, I think it is excellent. I had always feared that it was too soon for them to take over from me. And it was also that which I longed for the most. As such, this is the best parting gift anyone could have given this god of old.
Hey, what about me? Doesn't anyone feel the least bit of remorse for deceiving me? You've practically kept me in the dark!
I think that thanks would be more appropriate. You certainly played no small part in all of this, wreaking havoc and turning the city upside down. The Lord of Geo ought to thank you for your performance, if anything.
If you hadn't created the pressure of a battle between mortals, Adepti, and a god, the lump of coal resting in the hands of the Geo Archon, Liyue would never have been able to become a dazzling diamond of a city.
Huh? Just whose side are you on, mocking me like that? Are you itching for a fight? Hey, haven't you learned the Liyue saying, don't always call it as you see it?
Well then, with the Gnosis in my possession, I have no use for such idle chatter. We should return to Zapolyarny Palace and seek an audience with Her Majesty, the Tsaritsa. Come, Child.
Fine. I'll meet you there later. I'm not sharing a boat with the likes of you.
Do as you wish.
Now then, is there anything else you wish to ask me?
Right! As Zhongli always told us, a good trade is a fair trade. Paimon has no idea what could be a good trade for a Gnosis.
Realistically speaking, There is no such thing.
Huh?
However, I am the god of contracts. For thousands of years, I have made countless contracts. If the deal was of no benefit, then I certainly would not be inclined to agree to it. My agreement with the Cryo Archon will be the last of my contracts as the Geo Archon. My contract to end all contracts. As for the bargaining chip that the Tsaritsa used to balance the scales, uncover that answer for yourself in your future journeys.
Paimon can't absorb so much information at once. So, Zhongli, what sort of contract did you sign with the Cryo Archon?
One of the clauses of our contract was not to divulge any of its contents.
You're so petty. Today's the day of the rite of parting. Although the star of the show is fake, we spent so much time trying to organize it, it would be a real shame not to go there now.
Well, since we're going through with this rite of parting, I guess it means that those rumors hit the nail on the head.
So Rex Lapis is really... But they didn't catch the culprit, did they?
Oh, come on. Do you think that the assassin could have been a normal person? You know what I think? I don't think any of the gossip on the streets you hear from those shady types is worth anything. There's only one real possibility in my mind. I've heard that the assassin was that Fatui fellow. Youngish, pretty high in rank. I think they called him Child.
The Fatui? They certainly are very suspicious. Who knows what those greedy, crooked folks...
Shh! Lower your voice. If the Fatui catch you in their sights, Rex Lapis won't be around to protect you this time.
You know that god from the ocean couldn't have just shown up out of nowhere. I mean, it's been 2,000 years since Rex Lapis subdued it.
Yes, and to think that this happened right on the heels of the incident with Rex Lapis, too.
Say, do you think the person who assassinated our lord and released that evil god might have been one and the same?
Now that you mention it, that's very possible. Yes, it's very possible indeed. I mean, it all fits together. That person must have colluded with the evil god to harm Rex Lapis. Oh, that wicked, black-hearted scoundrel. Still, what sort of supernatural prowess must this person possess to be able to do such things? I have never heard of such a person in all my years.
Forget it. Guessing's no use to us. Look, the Millilith over there looks like he's about to make an announcement. Let's hear what the Ministry of Civil Affairs has to say first.
Hear ye all! The Chi Sing's words. Though a dragon soars ageless as the mountains, it too must return to dust. This is common knowledge. Gods and Adepti live glorious lives, but both light and shadow have their season. So too must they face divinely appointed trials. Rumors and hearsay abound on the streets that Rex Lapis was murdered. Now, let the truth be revealed. Having been thwarted in his trial, Rex Lapis's soul has recouped the celestial heights. He beseeches the people of Lyra to grieve not and to let not their hearts be saddened. Nor are they to believe street-born rumors or indulge in baseless speculation.
Paimon needs a translation on what the Qixing's announcement said. So that's how they're spinning it. Something feels off. Why would they suddenly give up looking for the murderer? Not to mention how this excuse sounds like something they just made up on the spot. Could the Qixing already have known that Rex Lapis wasn't dead? But Zhang Li said that neither they nor the Adepti knew anything. Did Zhang Li tell them in secret after his gnosis changed hands? Exactly, right? Ooh, seems like the rite of parting has been going on for a while now. Let's go have a look. Look, it's Ningguang and Kuching. Are they saying something? Are their speeches over?
As said previously, Rex Lapis's soul returning to the heavens is the end of the contract. And it is also the end of an era.
3,700 years of contracts burnt and reduced to ash.
We, the people of Liyue, were indeed prosperous. But blinded by our prosperity, we forgot that time can be pitiless.
The long, unending dream of our Archon walking among us.
Now that we have awoken from our dream, we must learn to say farewell. Will you stand with us as we reestablish our contracts? As we build a new age of prosperity?
So concludes the words of Her Eminence the Tianchuan. Does Her Eminence the Yuhang have anything to add?
Huh? Is she looking this way?
Traveler.
Yikes! She really is looking our way!
Is that the Traveler who they say defeated the ancient god?
So young!
The Liyue Qixing always repay their debts. And as you have heard, our eyes see far, and our reach is long. Name your price. You deserve that much.
Whoa!
Well, could you help me put up some missing person posters?
And to think I'd put my best perfume on before coming here, thinking you'd like it. But it seems as if those perfumes really were meant to be offered to Rex Lapis. Well, that's fine. Suffer no rivals in love, they say. And that's three gone in one stroke.
As for the mortals and Adepti of Liyue, what shape shall our relationship take from now on?
Ah, Rex Lapis, Rex Lapis. Now that I think about it, if everyone's of the same mind as me, perhaps mementos for Rex Lapis might be the best short-term business opportunity.
Hey, Zhongli! Look at this. Everyone in Liyue is caught up in their emotions, thinking that they'll never see Rex Lapis again. And here you are looking all relaxed.
Why would I not feel more at ease after laying down the burden I have borne for 3,700 years? Right. If the two of you can spare the time, I should treat you to a meal at the Xinyue kiosk.
Ha! That sounds like big talk, Zhongli. Paima might have believed you if you were treating us to some third-round knockout, but you'd have to pay out your nose just to stand inside Xinyue kiosk. Are you sure you can afford it?
You're right. I do lack the Mora. As the Rex Lapis Morax, I can easily create Mora. But since I have chosen to walk this earth as the mortal Zhongli, I should abide by the same rules that mortals do. When I was journeying with you, though I still had the Gnosis in hand, I knew that I must soon retire from my role as an Archon. So I had to rehearse a little for my new life.
Oh, no wonder! Paimon gets it now! You didn't look at the price tags when we were spending because you've never had to. But since you weren't used to not being able to just make more Mora as and when you wanted to, you had to try becoming a parasite to society who lives off of other people's credit.
Well, we were only spending Fatui money. You don't have to say it like that. In the City of Commerce, we do not merely exchange money or goods. We also exchange knowledge, memories, and foresight, as well as positions, roles, and lives. The Archon Morax could never experience life as the true mortal Zhongli could, no matter how many times he descended to be with his people. I must thank you for that. I will treasure the memories that I made as Zhongli, traveling the streets of Liyue with you. That is true. But there is no journey that does not end. No meetings without partings.
Paimon thinks that we should make a move and continue our search for the Seven.
I fear that continuing your journey may be difficult. The nation that neighbors Liyue by sea, Inazuma, is presently closed. The Electro-Archon Ball. And just as the people of Liyue preferred to call me Rex Lapis, she too goes by another name among locals in Inazuma.
Paimon thinks we've heard that one before. Raiden?
That is the case. And since Raiden is also the Shogun of Inazuma, people call her the Raiden Shogun.
That said, though people at the wharf were saying that the situation in Inazuma is very tense, Paimon doesn't remember that always being the case. It wasn't that bad last year. Zhongli, since you're Rex Lapis, shouldn't you know something about what's happening there? Just how did Inazuma become a closed nation?
It's because of visions.
Visions?
When faced with circumstances beyond their control, humans often bemoan their lack of power. But if a person shows true strength of will at a desperate and fateful moment in their life, the gods will look upon them with favor. This is what visions are. Magical foci bestowed upon those who have been acknowledged by the gods.
Uh-huh. That's how people in Teyvat see it.
But starting from last year, the Raiden Shogun began promulgating the Vision Hunt Decree.
Vision Hunt Decree?
Yes. It was an order to seize all visions within Inazuma's borders, and to inlay them upon the hands of the statue of the Omnipresent God.
They want to seize visions? But why? Aren't visions blessings from the gods?
I should think that in the Raiden Shogun's eyes, It is precisely because they are divine blessings that they should be under the sole dominion of divinity.
Whoa, that's harsh.
The Animo Archon is the god of freedom, and the Geo Archon is the god of contracts. For her part, the Raiden Shogun is the god of eternity. It seems as though she has finally decided to eliminate any unstable elements that could pose a threat to her eternal realm. The fact that even I, the oldest of the seven, have now passed away will only strengthen her resolve to pursue eternity. Knowing her, she must have again quoted that adage she is most fond of when proclaiming that decree to her people. Seven ideals for seven gods. And of these, eternity is nearest unto the heavenly principles. All right then. Was there anything else you wished to know? The time of the Adepti has long passed. If even the Liyue Qixing don't want to face that truth, then what future is there for Liyue? Kuching is absolutely right in saying this. Now, though I did laud Ningguang's desire for power, believing this to be a good thing, and thought as a matter of course that she must have been behind the Qixing's plan to take governing power over Liyue from the hands of the gods and Adepti, could the original person who brought up the idea of seizing power have been... All right then. Was there anything else you wished to know? Ah, that was a good one. Failing a divine trial. How they came up with that excuse, I will never know. That said, the reason why the Qixing were so eager to resolve the incident and stop pursuing the culprit was indeed because they received news in secret that Rex Lapis was not dead. I hinted as much to the Adepti as well. How did I accomplish that, you ask? Have you ever heard of this particularly convenient Adepti art known as gifting dreams and visions? All right then. Was there anything else you wished to know? Well then, I suppose you'll have to find a way to get inside this closed nation. Have patience. I suspect that some serendipity must first come into play. All right then. Well then.
I have gathered everyone here today to make an important announcement. Perhaps some of you will have heard the news already. I am, in fact, planning to rebuild the Jade Chamber.
Rebuild the Jade Chamber? That's a huge project!
So the rumors are true. No wonder the price of building materials has gone up so much lately.
The Jade Chamber means a lot to Lady Ningguang. Getting involved in this would be a huge opportunity.
Lady Ningguang, is there any way we can be of service?
Patience. Since the news made it out a few days ago, I have already had many people contacting me to declare an interest in joining the project. Nevertheless, I do have a few matters I should like to entrust to you here today. The building site has been chosen, and most of the materials have been assembled. Three key items are, however, still outstanding. They are as follows: Sunset Vermilionite, Wonder Cores, and Adepti Sigils.
Excuse my ignorance, Lady Ningguang. I'm familiar enough with Plastrite, but I've never even heard of those other two.
Only sufficiently large pieces of Plastrite, or specifically, Vermilionite, may earn themselves the Sunset moniker. This stone is what allows the Jade Chamber to float. Wonder Cores, meanwhile, are the central components of the mechanical structure of the Jade Chamber. Adepti Sigils serve as a means of integrating the mechanical devices with Adepti art. They are as indispensable as the mechanical core itself. Although these three items are rare, I trust that with your connections and capabilities, procuring them will not be a question of if, but of when. I take the saying, time is money, more seriously than most. Efficiency is everything. I will pay a generous price for the materials that you find. And in addition, the first three people who collect all the materials will have the opportunity to ask me a question. You may ask me anything, and I will give you an honest answer. I trust that this means of compensation will be to everyone's satisfaction.
These things won't be easy to get hold of, but if it means a chance to get some inside information on Liyue Harbor's development plan for next year...
Then it's the deal of a lifetime. Information from Lady Ningguang is priceless. Whoever gets to it first takes the market.
Haha, what a coincidence! I won't divulge too much, but I heard some murmurings about some Plastrite just the other day. So excuse me all, but, I have some business to do.
Oh, no. We better move quickly, or this opportunity will be snatched away from us.
Ningguang's rebuilding the Jade Chamber? This is a huge deal! Let's get involved!
So you heard my announcement, did you? What do you think? Interested? Yes. Providing the question pertains to something I am knowledgeable about.
Really? Ooh, then Paimon will ask you about how to run a business! Then we'll never be short of Mora ever again!
Of course. But how much information I share with you will depend on your performance. The construction of the Jade Chamber requires a great deal of space. The abandoned mine outside the Golden House has been selected as the building site. Once you have collected the materials, please, take them there. I have other business to attend to now. Otherwise, I would gladly escort you to the site in person. When you do arrive, please, seek out my secretary. Remember, this is a race against the clock. A rare opportunity presents itself to you. Do not let somebody else snatch it from your grasp.
Ningguang seems super busy. Come on, we'd better get going! First, we gotta get out of Yujing Terrace. Look! It seems like there's something kind of fishy going on over there.
Ma'am, you seem like an eminent and distinguished young lady to me. I can see that you're easily gonna win this procurement contest Lady Ningguang has set up. As it happens, we have some information about the materials that I really think might interest you. Come on, let's find somewhere a little more private, and we can get down to brass tacks.
No, I don't need it.
Ah, don't be like that.
Hey, come on, don't go! Why don't you stand there? After her!
Oh, right, yeah.
Did you hear that? They said they had some useful information! Information's just what we need right now. Let's follow them and see what we can find out.
Children, come, come. You've arrived at just the right moment. I've been looking for you.
Oh, what is it, Granny? Need any help?
Oh, no, no. You've done so much for Liyue Harbor already. I could hardly ask for more. In fact, my old friends and I have been putting our heads together to think of what sort of gift we might give you in return.
A gift? For Paimon?
Oh, child. You are so very modest. Uncommonly so, even. But you mustn't decline this gift. I simply won't allow it. When you traversed my old teapot in search of the cleansing bell, I heard your little friend mention that you often camp out in the wilds. That simply won't do. Especially since, I imagine, you still have a very long journey ahead of you. Fortunately, I have not yet grown so old as to see my subspace creation abilities atrophy. Oh, did my friends never mention that to you? Well then, it is a blessing we old folks once received from Rex Lapis, part of our illumination, if you will. I will not go into too much detail, but subspace creation is the ability to create a small, autonomous pocket world. The teapot that you entered previously was a little trinket created using that ability.
So, in the eyes of an Adeptus, creating a magic teapot world is just child's play, huh?
Oh, indeed, the teapot is nothing to boast of. One such as myself must depart from this realm to create a world of one's own. Rex Lapis, on the other hand, moved mountains and seas. That is what one might call an exercise of true power. But that's enough nostalgia for now. The gift that I have prepared for you just requires a few final materials to add the finishing touch.
That's right! Finding stuff's what we're good at, after all!
Oh, settle down now, children. There's no need for you to go running hither and thither. I have already found a fleet-footed youngster to prepare what I need. What's more, I doubt that you would know how to find the materials I am searching for. Some of them are very rare indeed these days. Well, for starters, I require some shimmer soil from the banks of Dihua Marsh. Back in the day, it could only be found where the glazed lilies thrived most profusely. You would have to dig downward, following the roots of the glazed lilies, and if you were lucky enough, you just might find a small patch of shimmer soil there. But almost no one has been able to find shimmer soil in this manner since Dihua Marsh came to be the way it is today. Even more difficult to find is Smaragdus jadeite, which must be chiseled from the rock of the chasm, or So it used to be. Ever since the Blackcliff Forge opened for business, they've slowly but surely stripped the mines all but completely bare of it. In any case, Smaragdus Jadeite is an Adepti treasure, and the Adeptal power within is not something that most humans can withstand. Extended contact with it is, in fact, harmful to humans. Ah, goodness knows if that child will succeed in finding these items.
Well, since you're an Adeptus, Granny, the person you asked for help, they must be an Adeptus too, right?
Yes. I suppose she does count as an Adeptus.
She counts? How come there are so many Adepti in Liyue Harbor? We seem to bump into them all the time. It feels like even when you go out to eat, you could be sitting next to an Adeptus and never even know it.
Oh, maybe so. Who can say? A fair few of my old friends are rather fond of mundane mortal life, after all.
I'm back, Granny. Oh, I don't believe we've met.
Ah, allow me to do the honors. This child here is Yen Fei. She's the one helping run some errands for me. Yen Fei, I believe you already heard of the Traveler and his traveling companion.
Of course, who hasn't? Much has been written about you in the Millilith's records. You became one of Liyue's most wanted after the Millilith marked you as a suspect following the incident at the Rite of Dissension. After which, you fought off the Millilith at Julian Karst and made contact with the Fatui, before finally defeating an ancient god together with Granny and her associates, and subsequently being cleared of any and all suspicion by the Qixing. What a shame. A shame that we didn't meet sooner. If we had, well, I can't say that I would have been able to clear you of suspicion immediately, but it certainly would have been less, embarrassing for you. Allow me to introduce myself once more. I'm Yen Fei, a legal advisor. Got a legal problem? You can come right to me! Oh, yes. Here's my business card. You'll find it has my contact details and office address. Keep it handy. If you have an urgent issue, just leave me a note at this address. Oh, and I almost forgot to mention, I offer a very generous discount for first-time customers.
All right, Yen Fei, all right. Let's get to the business at hand. I do not think these two are in any dire need of legal assistance at the moment. You'll have to excuse Yen Fei. She's always been like this, ever the talkative one when it comes to her own affairs.
Paimon was gonna ask the same question. You seem really different from the ones we've met before.
An Adeptus? I guess, kinda. My old man said he was one anyway. He mentioned that he once campaigned with Rex Lapis for a long old time, and then after that was all over, he went back and married my mom. They had me, and once I was all grown up, the two of them upped and left on a journey, leaving me with Granny here.
Well, that's a bit casual for an Adeptus. Aren't you guys supposed to sign solemn contracts to protect Liyue Harbor and all that stuff? What do you mean he just went back to get married?
Well, my dad did say that he'd talked it through with Rex Lapis and that he was fine with it. Even contributed towards the wedding gift, apparently. Anyway, let's not dwell on that too much. So, Granny, I've gotten a hold of most of the stuff you asked for, except for Smaragdus Jadeite. I couldn't find any at all.
Is that so? But Smaragdus Jadeite is really rather essential. Yen Fei, are you sure you can't find some other way? They have helped Liyue greatly, after all. It is only right that they are duly rewarded.
I know, Granny, you've told me 1,000 times already. Well, the chasm's definitely a no-go, but there's still a chance we can figure out some alternative means of procurement. Hold on a moment. Let me have a look.
Whoa! That's a really thick book! What kind of things do you write in there?
Commercial consultancy. Or... Snezhnaya? Ah! Found him! Krossel! A Snezhnayan merchant who once came to me with some legal queries on certain articles in the legal codices. If my memory serves, all of them had to do with rare ores. He mentioned that he was considering acquiring some Smaragdus jadeite to make hairpins, and wanted to know if there were any legal ramifications that he should be aware of. Said he was planning to sell them in Snezhnaya. So, I guess I'll go look for him. With any luck, he'll have gotten his hands on some Smaragdus jadeite, or might have an idea of where we can find some. Oh, you want to join me? I suppose that's no problem, but it's best if you just stand by and watch. If you try to get involved, you'll only risk placing yourself in legal jeopardy.
Wow, an Adeptus imploring us to avoid incurring legal liability. That's a first for sure. Best we be a little more careful than usual while we're with her.
Well, will you look at that, ma'am? Nowhere left to run. Don't worry, we're not bad guys. You give us some mora, we give you a little info. Everybody's a winner.
Boss, I got a bad feeling about this. Look at her, the white hair, the energy she gives off. I'm telling you, there's something different about her.
So what? She's loaded. How are we ever going to repay those gambling debts if we just let money walk away from us, huh?
I've already told you. I don't need your information. If you still can't grasp that, I'm happy to repeat it in a way that won't be so easy to forget.
Come on, ma'am. You seem like an intelligent lady. I shouldn't have to spell this out to you. It's not about whether you need the info or not, okay? It's about you taking out your money and handing it over, and nobody getting hurt.
I won't...
No more excuses! Okay. I know you have money. I saw you. Yeah, I saw you. Strolling into Leo Lee Pavilion, ordering a table full of food, and only taking a few bites. Then Xinyue Kiosk, then Wanmin Restaurant. Same story each time. You order all the signature dishes, take a few bites, then you're on your way again. How could you afford to be so wasteful if you weren't from a rich family? And since you're so rich, what's the loss to you in giving us a little spare change, huh?
Master warned me not to lay a hand on anyone in Liyue Harbor. But here we are. Perhaps... yes. Let's call it fate.
Boss, I'm telling you, something's not right.
What are you afraid of? We're just selling information. It's not illegal. If she lays a finger on us, all the better. We'll sue her for everything she's worth.
Oh, you again.
The Millilith? What are the Millilith doing here? Did you do this? You ought to mind your own business. I swear!
Silence! How dare you threaten innocent civilians? You're coming with us.
No, don't be angry, sir. Please, let me explain.
Shenhe.
Shenhe?
My name.
Oh, so your name's Shenhe. Paimon's name is... well, Paimon. And this is Paimon's travel buddy.
Oh, I've heard about you two before. Thank you for helping to defuse the situation. I could have dealt with it myself, though. I suspect smashing his head against the ground a handful of times is all it would have taken to get him to surrender.
You can't do that! That's way too violent! This is Leela Harbor! There are laws against that kind of stuff, you know!
Laws? No, apparently not.
Really? So how exactly have you...
That would be my stomach growling. I haven't eaten enough.
She's so honest. Wait, that's right! They said you went around all the restaurants ordering this and that and the other, but only took a small bite of each dish. Then of course you're still hungry. So, anything in particular you're hungry for?
Chingsen, glazed lily, violet grass. These are my usuals. Medicinal herbs?
Kinda hard to explain. Anyway, Boo Boo Pharmacy's not far away. Let's take Shenhe there for a big medicinal meal. After all, you can't work on an empty stomach. Psst. Do you think Shenhe might be an Adeptus? It seems like it's her first time in Liyue Harbor, and she doesn't seem to get how things work here. If she is an Adeptus, that would explain everything. Where does she fit in with the other Adepti, though? Paimon's super curious.
Are you here to buy some herbs? I do hope you brought your prescription.
Chingsen, glazed lily, and violet grass, please. Half a pound of each.
What kind of prescription is this? Sounds more like a lunch order. Oh, here you go. That's everything we have in stock.
Thank you.
She's really eating them!
My hunger has now abated. Thank you. Rather awful. Though they were not completely devoid of sweet fragrance, after consuming a large quantity of them, bitterness is all that remains.
So, how come you chow down on these and barely touch the restaurant food? If Paimon had enough Mora, Paimon would go to the fanciest restaurant in town and order a whole table of food and eat it all in one go!
Because I'm not sure whether I will remain here in the future. The food of the mortal realm is most delicious, but should I return to the mountains, yearning for the food here shall only pose an obstacle to my continued spiritual development. Sampling each dish in order to appreciate its taste is enough.
Return to the mountains! That proves it! Paimon knew she was an Adeptus!
Enough about me. What are your plans from here?
Oh, right! Paimon almost forgot! We came out to take part in the Rebuild the Jade Chamber competition! And now we're probably super behind because we've been held up for so long.
I see. I heard something about the contest when I was passing by.
Yep! You get to ask Ningguang any question you want if you win! Were you interested in the contest too, Shenhe?
I came for the rebuilding of the Jade Chamber, but until this point I had no intention of joining a contest. However, you have shown me your kindness, and I would now like to lend you my assistance. Oh, don't worry. I ask for nothing in return.
Wow! You really don't have to! But having an Adeptus help out will make things a whole lot easier, so...
Then let's not delay. I have a plan.
Great! Paimon bets this is gonna be the awesomest plan ever!
I am not sure whether or to what extent this plan can be classified as awesome. I do, however, believe it will be highly effective. We simply need to dispose of everyone who is currently ahead of us. Then, we alone shall become the victors.
Veto! That is not acceptable! Not by a long shot!
Really? But I hear that competition is in essence about conflict and one-upmanship.
Look, we want to win this competition fair and square, okay? Sunset Vermilionite, Wonder Cores, and Adepti Sigils. Let's start at the top of the list and work down. So, for Plastrite...
I was wondering who I could hear arguing over there. So, it's you.
Baishu? What are you doing out here?
Lady Ningguang wishes to purchase a large batch of wound dressing. We're running low at the store, so I came out to fetch the ingredients personally.
Huh? How come Lady Ningguang needs so much wound dressing all of a sudden?
I'm not too sure, I did hear she's looking to rebuild the Jade Chamber. Maybe for its first aid on site? I didn't ask, though. Far be it from me to pry into my customer's personal affairs. Oh, and she also borrowed Chi-Chi. Meaning Boo Boo Pharmacy is very short-handed right now. I don't suppose any of you are looking for part-time work by any chance?
No, no. We've got other stuff to do. While you're here, though, you seem to know a lot. Have you ever heard of something called Sunset Vermilionite?
Ah, the variety of plostrite used in the Jade Chamber, yes? There is some mention of it in the Seven Mountain Treatises. When activated, Sunset Vermilionite rises up all the way into the clouds. It's very rare indeed. As far as the records show, virtually all Sunset Vermilionite in existence has been mined and taken possession of. But the Feiyun Commerce Guild would know far more about this than I do.
Okay then, let's go ask at the Feiyun Commerce Guild. Thanks, Baiju.
You're quite welcome. Good luck to you all. And if there's anything further you need from me, just come to the Boo Boo Pharmacy.
Declare your commercial goods.
any poisonous mushrooms inside.
Declare your commercial goods. Thank you.
seat. My.
Traveler, please, over here. It has been a while since you joined the Adventurers Guild. Are your adventures going smoothly? Is that so? Apart from your own skills, reliable teammates are also indispensable when adventuring. Another person to count on is always good after all. But recruiting such dependable companions is no easy matter, is it?
Yep, and it's even harder to get a guide as good as Paimon.
Ah, yes. I do have some information that may be of help to you. Let me consult our records. Ah, there it is. There's been a certain blonde stranger who arrived in Mondstadt lately, dressed in most unusual clothes.
Blonde. Dress is all funny. It feels like Paimon's heard this one before. Wait, do you mean... Does that stranger's face look anything like his?
Hmm? Like the honorary knights? No, they couldn't look more different. This stranger is a very tall man, and even has an eye patch.
Seriously? How does this have anything to do with Kaya? Eye patches can't prove that you're related anyway!
That stranger declined the guild's invitation, so I can't say that I know anything about the relationship between him and Mr. Kaya. Nonetheless, you can look for him if you're interested. Perhaps he might accept your commission instead. After all, it is not uncommon for some adventurers to not want to be limited by the guild, but be happy to accept a fellow adventurer's requests. And should this stranger be a strong adventurer indeed, he would certainly be a big help on your journey. Please don't talk down on yourself like that. You are the honorary knight of the Knights of Favonius, after all. Your deeds are the stuff of song for all the bards in the city, even now. Well, as to further news about him, you may want to ask Mr. Lawrence. He stands guard at the city gate, so he may know something about that stranger. I wish you every success, adventurer.
Mondstadt welcomes you.
Honorary knight. Is something the matter? A stranger with an eye patch. Let me think. Oh yeah, I remember seeing someone like that. A blonde stranger dressed in unusual garb. He was wandering all over Mondstadt at first, which I found rather suspicious. So I decided to keep an eye on him for a while. I lost him pretty quickly. Still, I didn't think that this was such a huge matter that we needed our outrider to pursue him by air. As long as Master Jean is here, there's nothing to fear from some suspicious, unusual-looking person.
That might be true, but if it were up to Jean, she'd take this way more seriously.
That is true. But on the other hand, knowing that Master Jean may overreact to the situation is all the more reason to not tell her, no? Anyways. Oh yeah, he was at Wagner Smithy for a while before I tried telling him. He might have said something to Wagner. You should go ask him. Maybe he has more news about our stranger.
What? You need something? Here. I remember him. He showed up a few days ago asking to buy a bunch of forging materials. Can't say I've heard of any of the materials he mentioned, though. He then had a look at the weapons in my shop before leaving. I've heard that he can be found drinking at the Angel's Share. If the Knights of the Guild want to get hold of him, that's the only place to be.
The Angel's Share? Well, Master Diluc probably has his eye on that stranger too, then. Anyway, let's go to the Angel's Share and have a look.
Hard work is all there is to the craft.
What will it be? Grape juice or apple cider?
Hey, Charles! Have you seen a blonde stranger who wears an eye patch around here by any chance?
That I have. He comes here every night. Just to drink, though. Doesn't order anything else. He even sometimes mixes his own drinks after he orders them. I don't know anything else about him, but from his selections and mixes, I'd say that he's quite the connoisseur.
And what's Master Diluc's opinion?
Why, I just gave it to you. Quite the connoisseur.
Investigating everything as always. Guess that's Diluc for you.
If you're looking for that gentleman, he ordered some new bottle of wine in advance yesterday. So he should be here today, too. There's too many raucous patrons on the first floor, so if you want to wait, best to go to the second. Ah, welcome, sir. The wine that you previously ordered is here.
He's really here? Let's go downstairs and have a look.
Come, my friend. Wine and adventure.
I need to...
Another...
No intention of paying us any mind, huh?
A traveler, you say? Why are you traveling? Well, that's as good a reason as any. Sit down over there, then.
So, guess we've broken the ice. What a weird guy.
That little one beside you.
That's not true, and you know it.
It's indeed a good thing to have someone accompany you on your travels. My name's Dainsleif. I suppose you have some business with me? Sure.
And he was so cold just a moment before. Paimon's got a bad feeling about this.
But I will require advance payment. 500 mora, and 3 answered questions. The 500 is a one-time fee, and we'll settle the questions in a moment. That's it.
Well, now Paimon's got a really bad feeling. That kind of compensation can't be right.
Ah, thank you. Now, as for my questions, I'd like you to answer them here and now. The answer to a question says nothing about right and wrong, only about differences in attitude. I only wish to know what your choices are. You need only answer. Question 1. The crisis Mondstadt faced was resolved by an alliance between yourself and that Animo Archon who calls himself Venti. Who, in your view, was the key to ending that crisis? I know everything that I should. Well, answer the question. Is that your answer? I see. Question 2. Rex Lapis, who has defended Liyue Harbor for millennia on end, used his gnosis to lay down a contract to end all contracts, of which the stipulations are still unknown. Who do you think will defend Liyue Harbor in the future, now that they've lost their deity? So that's your answer? Now for my final question. This world has people who gained visions, and those who did not. Which of the two do you think hold more importance in the eyes of the gods? So, this is your answer then. I understand.
As I thought, you really are similar to her.
I'll take that 500 mora. And now I also understand your views on this world. As we agreed, you may now commission me. That said, I only take commissions related to the Abyss Order. Like you, I am currently on a journey. You intend to find your sibling, while I wish to oppose the Abyss. Ugh. Those creatures that serve the Abyss are the fangs and claws by which the Order spreads chaos in this world. I have come to Mondstadt this time while on the trail of an Abyss Herald.
An Abyss Herald?
An even more twisted abyssal being, one that commands the Abyss Mages.
Oh, that's right! We've just been fighting against the Fatui and Liyue, who are human too! We haven't encountered the non-human Abyss Order at all!
There's some reason behind that, I'm afraid. It's possible that they may have been under orders to avoid your path.
Oh, that does sound pretty dangerous. Maybe they're looking for a better time to ambush us or something. We're super duper strong!
That manner, it's just like hers.
Well then, let's go see for ourselves, shall we? According to the leads I have on hand, the Abyss Order has re-infiltrated the Temple of the Falcon. Let's meet up at the temple. Perhaps your questions about the Abyss will be answered there.
Even if you are a close friend.
Someone to chat to would be better than just standing around.
This abandoned temple does bear some marks of the abyss. The Falcon of the West. Though it can soar in the wind, it ultimately does naught but hover under the light of the gods. Hmm? Oh, it's nothing. Let's head inside. Now.
Paimon wonders what the Abyss Heralds look like. Do they look something like the Abyss Mages?
Let's head further in first. If we do see that creature, that'll spare me the explanation either way.
Up a little. You're in for a little shock.
Help! do it!
Smash!
Kick, kick, surrender and be gentle. Kick, kick.
Ha! Oh, go, Bucky!
Kick.
Just a few Abyss Mages? Seems like that Herald might have already left. The Abyss. It is chaos, and it is also destruction. It is a morass of inconceivable madness that encroaches upon this world's very foundations. That is why even the Dragon of the East, a servant of a deity, was unable to resist its corrosive powers. And the creatures of the Abyss desire nothing less than the overthrow of a world ruled by the Archons.
You seem to know a lot about the Abyss, Dane.
Well, we do have some history. I suppose that's as far as chit-chat goes. We should head to Wolvendom. Judging by the traces I'm following, their next appearance may be within the territory of that old wolf. Perhaps we may find our Abyss Herald there.
You've been a naughty boy.